A layer is a virtual surface on which light events occur, such as creating a color, a pre-programmed graphic shape within the fixture, or graphic content derived from console, media server, pixel mapping softwares. Our Claypaky light fixtures allow the simultaneous use of multiple layers of effect, in combination with each other. For each layer, they offer dedicated channels to control dimmer and shutter and make management of graphic content coming from an external source easier. The lowest layer is dedicated to the background color, allowing RGBW mixing. The middle layer is the level that enables pixel-to-pixel management. The highest layer is dedicated to the pre-programmed shapes within the fixture. Starting from the lowest priority level, the priority sequence is as follows. Background layer. Pixel layer. Shape layer. Now you can observe all the layers working simultaneously on the array of pixels. Now we're going to show how to configure a fixture so that advanced layers management can be used. In this specific case, we patched, on the console, the basic engine of 8 Tambor arrays in advanced mode. Then, we created a group for each instance, corresponding to a layer that manages all its attributes. Pixel Engine can be controlled either from the same console as Basic Engine or from a second controller. In this case, we patched the Pixel Engine of 8 Tambor arrays fixture types onto a second controller and applied an effect. Now, we are going to show each individual layer and their functional hierarchy. The main dimmer acts as a master dimmer for all specific dimmers for the individual layers. Let's now set the main dimmer to 100%. Turn on the dimmer channel of the background instance and assign the color mauve. Next, select the shape instance, turn on the dimmer, assign the color cyan, and apply a dynamic shape. You can now observe how the chosen shape overwrites the color set on the background layer. We lower the dimmers for both the background layer and the shape layer. Now, we are going to show the effect produced by the pixel layer. Select the pixel instance and turn the dimmer up. The pixel instance allows for the control of the intensity and shutter of the pixel engine, while the second external controller handles color management. Now, select the background instance and turn on the dimmer channel. Notice how the effect running on the pixel layer overwrites the color set on the background layer. Let's select the shape instance and increase the intensity. In this case, shape instance takes priority over the other two layers. Shape and pixel layers have two additional functions, master and slave. These functions modify the behavior of a specific layer when the dimmer is set to zero and impact the layers beneath it. The background layer does not have these functions because it is at the lowest level. When a layer with colors set at a certain value and dimmer set at 0 is in master mode, the LEDs involved turn black. When a layer with colors set at a certain value and a dimmer at 0 is in slave mode, the LEDs involved become transparent. Let's consider the background and shape layers. Select the shape instance and activate the master function via the shutter channel. Notice that when we set the shape instance's dimmer to 0, the layer remains active, and the LEDs involved turn black. This function can be useful for various applications, such as applying a dimmer effect to the shape instance. Now, let's see what happens when we apply the slave function to the shape layer. Select the shape instance and activate the slave function via the shutter channel. In this case, when the dimmer is set to 0, the layer remains active but becomes transparent. The LEDs involved take on the color of the underlying layer. The transition between layers is controlled by the transition channel. This channel allows you to adjust how smoothly the layer is inserted. Observe some examples that leverage the interaction of layers and the functions described above. Now, let's see how we created them.